Welcome, Chuala, for the next session for the new chapter, chapter 3, application of integration. We have learned different type of integrations according to the specified functions for specific methods, how to integrate the given functions. We have learned many type of integral functions in our second chapter, integration with the basics. Now we have moved to the next chapter. Here we are applying the integration related to the area of the region bounded by the curves. So this is one of the application of integration, to find the area of the region bounded by the curves with a coordinate axis, either by x-axis or y-axis. The area of the region bounded by the curves is an application problem. Here we have mentioned the curves. Curve means it has the power, it will not have a linear power, it has more than degree 1. So y equal to x square is a parabolic curve. Y equal to minus x square is a parabolic curve. Y equal to x cube is also a curve. For this type of curves, or y equal to a parabolic curve, x square plus x minus 2, this is also a parabolic curve. These types of curves covered some area between particular interval with the coordinate axis. We can find those type of areas by using the integration. So using integration, we can evaluate the area bounded by the curves with the coordinate axis. We can also calculate the area between two given curves. For example, this is a parabola, y equal to x square. Here, this is origin, this is x is equal to 1, and here x is equal to 2. To find the area between x-axis, the curve y equal to f of x, and x is equal to 1 to x is equal to 2. So this particular area will be calculated by using our integration. The particular area between 1 to 2 with the curve y equal to f of x, this is y equal to f of x with the curve y equal to f of x, and the coordinate axis x-axis limit x is equal to 1 to 2, the curve y equal to f of x, between we have some area, we can calculate that area by using integration. So here this type of curve is also it's a parabola. When a particular limit is mentioned, we can calculate the area between the particular interval with the coordinate axis and with the parabola. So these type of areas will be calculated now. So we have formula to calculate these areas. The first one, the area here, y equal to f of x is a curve, let it be the y equal to f of x, y equal to f of x is a curve. This is coordinate axis, x-axis, y-axis, origins taken here. Given some point x is equal to a and x is equal to b. Now, the curve y equal to f of x with the coordinate axis, x-axis, between the interval x is equal to a to b, covers some area. To find this type of area, we have formula. Here the curve is y equal to f of x, and limits are x is equal to a to x is equal to b, y equal to f of x. Y is a function of x, the limits are in x. X is a function of y, the limits will be in y. Now here y equal to f of x, the function of x means x, the limits are x is equal to a, x is equal to b. To find the area above the x-axis, this is the area covered by the curve above the x-axis. For that, we have formula area equal to area bounded by y equal to f of x, y equal to f of x between the limits x is equal to a to x is equal to b with the x-axis, with the x-axis is given by the formula, integral is given by the formula, area equal to integral x is equal to a to x is equal to b, this is lower limit, this is upper limit, x is equal to a to x is equal to b, y dx, we can write here y dx, y is nothing but the given function f of x, y dx, or integral x a to b, f of x dx, we can write both the way, x is equal to a to x is equal to b, y dx, or x is equal to integral a to b, x is equal to a to x is equal to b, f of x dx, because y equal to f of x, we can write both the way, this is the formula. After substituting the given function here, we can integrate, we'll get the answer. That will be the area covered by the curve y equal to f of x between x is equal to a to x is equal to b. Now, the area of the region bounded by the curve y equal to f of x is equal to a to x is equal to b when below the x-axis, if it is below the x-axis. Now, the area bounded by the curve, this is above the x-axis, for above the x-axis, above the x-axis. Now, it is for below the x-axis, if it covers below the x-axis. For example, I'm drawing here. Suppose the curve is taken here. Between the same limit. Now I will change the limits also. So x is equal to a to b. We will keep the same limit. Here x is equal to a. Here x is equal to b taken. Y equal to f of x. Now the curve y equal to f of x. Between the limit x is equal to a to x is equal to b. So, area bounded by the curve y equal to f of x between x is equal to a to x is equal to b below the x-axis, with the x-axis, that is below the x-axis, with the below the x-axis, below the x-axis, that is the area covered here. The curve covers below the x-axis. The formula equal to area equal to minus integral a to b y dx. If it covers above the x-axis, the formula is a to b, x is equal to a to x is equal to b y dx plus y dx. If it covers below the x-axis, area equal to minus x is equal to a to x is equal to b minus integral x is equal to a to x is equal to b y dx, or x is equal to a to x is equal to b minus f of x dx. If it covers below the x-axis, you should add minus with the previous formula, that's all. So we have introduced two formulas. One is area bounded by the curve between some limit above the x-axis. And now that is first one. The second one is area bounded by the curve between x is equal to x is, a to x is equal to b below the x-axis, that is known as for that we have formula a equal to minus x is equal to a to x is equal to b integral x is equal to a to x is equal to b y dx, or integral x is equal to a to x is equal to b minus f of x dx, we can write. We have two more formulas similar to this. When the curve covers with the y-axis, now look at here. Suppose the curve as a function of y, x is equal to f of y, x is a function of y, x is equal to f of y, covers the right of y axis, that is right of y axis, let it be taken here, right side of the y axis, between the limit y equal to c to y equal to d. Some limit are taken, c to d is some limit from y axis. y equal to c2, y equal to d with the y-axis. This is the curve x is equal to f of y, covers the limit with the y-axis between y equal to c2, y equal to d. This is the area mentioned here. To find this type of area, we have formula. This is right of y-axis, that is very important. And the previous formula, above x-axis and below x-axis, we have below x-axis minus will be added. Here, the right of x-axis, the area equal to integral y equal to c2, y equal to d. When the function in terms of y, the limits in the terms of y. So, y equal to c2, y equal to d, x into dx is a function of y, so x dy, or it can be written as integral c to d f of y dy, f of y dy. This is the area covered by the curve right of the y-axis between y equal to c2, y equal to d. Suppose the same curve covers at the left of the y-axis, that is taken here. This is the x is equal to f of y, the curve between the limit y equal to c2 and y equal to d, but it covers left of the y-axis, left of the y-axis. In this case, the formula to find that area is area a equal to integral y equal to c2, y equal to d minus x dy, r is equal to minus integral y equal to c2, y equal to d, x is equal to f of y dy. So these are the four formulas. Here I have introduced two more formulas for the curve covers with the y-axis. Previously we have two more formulas when the curve covers with the x-axis. Above x-axis, a equal to integral a to b y dx. Below x-axis, integral a to b minus y dx. If it is right of the y-axis, integral c to d x dy. If it is left of the y-axis, integral c to d minus x dy, or minus integral y equal to c to d x dy. These are the four formulas applied in the coming exercise. For the all above four cases, the curve y equal to f of x and x is equal to f of y or g of y, the defined functions are continuous between the defined intervals. That is very important. All the functions are continuous functions between the defined interval. And here we have one more formula, but we are not using here in our exercise or in our text, but it will be important. Area between two curves, the common area between two curves. Area between two curves. Or it is also known as common area covered by the curves. There are two functions, f of x and g of x. Both are continuous functions on the defined interval AB. Both are continuous on the defined interval AB. Now, for example, this is one of the curve, and another curve is like this way. Here, this is taken as f of x, and this curve is taken as g of x. There are two curves, one is f of x, another one is g of x. Here, y equal to f of x, then y equal to g of x, two curves. Now, both are intersecting and two points. Both are intersecting two points. That is taken here the limits. X is equal to a to x is equal to b. That is the limit taken x is equal to a to x is equal to b. They are the intersection points of on the x-axis. So intersection points between the curve, they are taken at the x-axis as the limit. X is equal to a to x is equal to b. That is the limit x is equal to a to x is equal to b. Now, to calculate this common area between the curve, we can calculate this area between the curve by using the formula area equal to integral a to b lower limit to upper limit, then f of x minus g of x g of x into dx, f of x minus g of x, because when we calculate the area of f of x from origin to this point, the total area with the x-axis will be covered. And then subtracting g of x, the g of x covers this point to this point. The total area, the unshaded portions covered by g of x. Listen carefully here. The shaded and unshaded portions area covered by f of x, and the unshaded portions only covered by g of x. When we subtract the unshaded portion from the shaded and unshaded portions, we will get the only shaded portion. That is our required area. That is calculated by the formula area equal to integral a to b f of x minus g of x dx. So this is the formula used to calculate the area covered by two curves. So this is also known as common area between two curves. Now we are entering into the exercise. Question number 1 in exercise 3.1. Using integration, find the area of the region bounded by the line 2y plus x is equal to 8, the axis and the lines x is equal to 2 to x is equal to 4. Not only the formulas are applicable for the curves, but for a straight line also it is applicable. A particular line covered with the x-axis or y-axis between the defined limit, we can find the area. Here there is a line given. Look at here. The given line is 2y plus x is equal to 8, and with the x-axis given, and between the lines means between the limits. Just we draw a rough diagram here. So we can draw a rough diagram here. To draw a rough diagram, first of all find y. Now 2y equal to 8 minus x, and y equal to 8 minus x divided by 2. I form a small table here that includes x and y. Now put x is equal to 0 first, and then substitute y equal to 0, because it is a line, it must intersect the x and y axis at some of the points. Here when put x is equal to 0, when we substitute x is equal to 0, y equal to 8 by 2 is 4, and then we substitute y equal to 0, 8 minus x is equal to 0, which implies x is equal to 8. Form a small table here. Put y equal to x is equal to 0 first, then y equal to 0 first. Anyway, substitute x is equal to 0 and y equal to 0 in the given equation. You will get two more answers. When x is equal to 0, y become 4, and when y equal to 0, x become 8. By use of this data, we can draw a diagram. X-axis, y-axis, this is origin. Look at here, this is a point 0 comma 4, another point is 8 comma 0. 0 comma 4 means it lies here. Sorry, 0 comma 4, it is lies here, 0 comma 4. And 0 comma 8, that is 8 comma 0, the points are taken from x comma y. 0 comma 4, x 0, y 4 here, pointed here, and then x 8, y 0, this means 8 comma 0. Approximately I am plotting here, not exactly, this is an approximate diagram. 8 comma 0, the points are, you can write the points here without any confusion. We can plot 0 comma 4 and 8 comma 0. There are two points here we have. One is 0 comma 4, another one is 8 comma 0. Plotting 0 comma 4 and 8 comma 0, draw a line passing through the two points. This is the line representing y equal to 8 minus x by 2. Here we have defined, they have defined limit between 2 to 4. Here is 8, approximately mark here. Here x is equal to 2 is taken, and x is equal to 4 is drawn here. These are the two lines. Now we should calculate the area between x is equal to 2 to x is equal to 4 and the line y equal to 8 minus x by 2 with the x-axis. So this is the shaded region is the required area to calculate now. So this is the area we should calculate. This is the area covered above the x-axis between x is equal to 2 to x is equal to 4. Therefore, we have formula area A equal to area bounded by the curve above the x-axis integral x is equal to A to x is equal to B y dx. X is equal to A to x is equal to B y dx. I have calculated y value equal to x 8 minus x by 2 here. Now, we can simplify this also. That means equal to 4 minus x by 2 also you can use. So, substituting here, area equal to, our limit is 2 to 4. Y dx, y is 8 minus x by 2 or 4 minus x by 2. I am substituting here 1 by 2 into 8 minus x. We can change it as 1 by 2 into 8 minus x. For our convenience, we can change the function without changing its meaning. Here 1 by 2 into 8 minus x into dx. Can substitute here. Substituting. This is equal to integral 2 to 4. 1 by 2 is taken out constant. Now integrating the function into the integrating the function now, 8 is 8x minus x means x power 1 dx, that is x square by 2, substituting limit 2 to 4 here. Now it will be equal to 1 by 2 into, substituting upper and lower limit value, substituting the upper limit 8 into 4, 32, minus 4 square by 2, 16 by 2. Now we have completed the upper limit value, then minus of the lower limit, substituting lower limit 2 here, 8 2s are 16, minus here 2 square means 4 by 2. That's all. This is simplify this, we will get a half of 1 by 2 into 32 minus 16. Here 16 by 2 is 8. So 32 minus 8. Here we have 24. So simplifying these two. Here we can cancel it by 2, 8. 32 minus 8 is 24. And minus. Here 4 by 2 is 2. So 16 minus 2 is 14. So look at here. 32 minus 8, 24, and minus of 16 minus 2 is 14, so minus 14. Can simplify this again, 1 by 2 into 24 minus 14, 10. By simplifying, we have 5 square units. So area covered by the line y equal to 8 minus x by 2 between x is equal to 2 to x is equal to 4 is 5 square units. We are in question number 2, exercise 3.1. Given line y minus 2x minus 4 equal to 0. And the limits are y equal to 1, y equal to 3 on y axis. We should find the area covered by the line with y axis between the limit y equal to 1 and y equal to 3. So the limits are given in the y axis. The formula is area equal to integral y equal to c to y equal to d x dy. After tracing the curve or tracing the line only we can define it is minus x dy or plus x dy. So first form a small table, in it put x comma y and substitute x 0 then y 0. Put x is equal to 0 here, y minus 4 equal to 0. When x is equal to 0, which implies y minus 4 equal to 0, so y equal to 4. When x is 0, y follows 4. And then substitute y equal to 0 here. When y equal to 0, minus 2x minus 4 equal to 0, minus 2x is equal to 4, then x is equal to minus 2. So now there are two points here, one is 0 comma 4 and another one is minus 2 comma 0. These are the two points, the line, given line intersecting at x and y axis. Now we can draw a diagram according to it.
Z
0, 4 and -2, 0. X, Y axis are chosen here. This is the origin. And 0, 4 means this is the point 0, 4 approximately I am plotting here. And -2, 0, this is the point -2, 0. Taken -2, 0. The required line passes through, the given line passes through the two points 0, 4 and -2, 0. Here the given limits are y equal to 1 to y equal to 3. Taken y equal to 1 here and y equal to 3 here. The area in between y equal to 1, y equal to 3, we have some area. We should find this area between y equal to 1 to 3 with the y axis. Look at the diagram here. Now, the area covered is left of the y axis. The area covered is left of the y axis. So, in the formula, we should change minus x dy or minus integral y equal to c to y equal to d x dy. If it forms in the right of the y axis, the formula is x dy. Now the area required area formed in the left of the y axis, the formula we should have negative. So above x axis positive, below x axis negative, and right of y axis is positive, left of y axis is negative. So here we are pointing minus integral c to d x dy. Here taking the formula, respective formula, area equal to minus integral y equal to c to y equal to d x dy. Now substituting the function as x here, given y minus 2x minus 4 equal to 0. So y minus 4 equal to 2x here, x is equal to 1 by 2 y minus 4. Now substituting the function here, a equal to minus integral c to d, lower limit to upper limit 1 to 3 x dy, x is 1 by 2 into y minus 4 into dy, which will be equal to minus 1 by 2 into integrating y square by 2 minus 4y, limit is 1 to 3. Substituting here minus 1 by 2 into substituting upper limit 3 square 9 by 2 minus 12 minus of the lower limit 1 by 2 minus 4 here, which is equal to minus 1 by 2 into 9 by 2 minus 12, taking 9 minus 24 by 12. Or we can simplify this, multiply this minus inside. This is equal to minus 1 by 2 into 9 by 2 minus 12 and minus 1 by 2 plus 4. We can easily simplify now. 9 by 2 minus 1 by 2 is 8 by 2, that is 4. So these two become 4, and remaining minus 12 plus 4 is minus 8. Can simplify this again, minus 1 by 2 into minus 4 should be equal to 2 plus 2 square units. That is the area covered by the line between the limit y equal to 1 to 3, the left of the y axis. Now question number 3, exercise 3.1. Find the area of the parabola y square to 4ax to its lattice rectum, covered by its lattice rectum. So y square to 4ax parabola is open rightward. This is y square equal to 4ax. Vertex 0, 0. This is the origin. And focus f of a, 0. Lattice rectum. What is lattice rectum? A perpendicular focal chord is lattice rectum. Perpendicular focal chord. Chord passes through the focus, making 90 degree with the x axis. That is, perpendicular focal chord is known as lattice rectum. So you should find the area of these two portions. Now I'm taking the area covered above the x-axis. And multiply it by 2, will get the remaining part. Because the parabola is symmetrical to the x-axis. Symmetric to the x-axis. So, above and below covers equal area. We can find the area found by x is equal to 0 to, this is y-axis, x is equal to 0 to, x is equal to a. And then multiply it by 2, we will get the total area. Covered with its lattice rectum. So, area above the x-axis. So, formula is area a equal to integral x is equal to a to x is equal to b y dx. But required area equal to 2 times integral 0 to a. Here is a comma 0, x is equal to a in this point. So, 0 to a. X is equal to 0 to x is equal to a, y dx. Y means y square equal to 4ax given. Then y equal to root of 4ax. That is 2 root a root x. 2 into a power half into x power half. Y equal to 2 a power half x power half. That is taking square root. Y equal to root of 4ax. Separating root. Root of 4 is 2, then root of a is written as a power half, then x to the power half. So, y equal to 2 a power half x power half. That is written here 2 into a power 1 by 2, x power 1 by 2 into dx. Now, the required area is 2 times integral 0 to a y dx. Instead of y, I have substituted 2 a power half y power half. Now, integrating the above value, 2a power half is constant taken out. So, 2 into 2a power half, 4 into a power half, integral x power half into dx. This is integrated by the formula x power n, that is equal to 4a power half into x power n dx is x power n plus 1 by n plus 1, x power 1 by 2 plus 1 is 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2. Limit 0 to a. Now this 3 by 2 will turn as 2 by 3 in the numerator. That is equal to 4 into 2 by 3 into a power 1 by 2. Now substituting upper limit and lower limit. By upper limit it is a power 3 by 2. By lower limit it is 0. Because the 3 by 2 is taken out. In the numerator it is reciprocal, so 4 into this 3 by 2 become 2 by 3 here, then a power half, the remaining is x power 3 by 2, limit 0 to a, substituting the upper limit, a power 3 by 2 minus the lower limit 0, 0. Now which is equal to 4 2s are 8 by 3, a power half into a power 3 by 2, half plus 3 by 2. Half plus 3 by 2 equal to 4 by 2 equal to 2. So, 8 into a square. 8 by 3 a square is square units. So, it is a general formula. The parabola y square to 4ax covers with the x-axis with the lattice rectum is 8 by 3 a square. 8 by 3 a square units.